Go to the Tools panel of Illustrator and select the Ellipse tool. Hold down the Shift and create a quick circle. Very basic one. Set the color to red, green, etc. Once you've done that, go to the Symbols panel. You can find that in the Window menu, Symbols panel. However, you can save this, but to give it a bit of depth before you go any further, I would suggest maybe go to Effect and down to Stylize and Drop Shadow. So you can add a quick drop shadow, maybe go for 30, just so you can get it. It's always defaults to about 7 or so. Once you've got that, what you can do, you can then drag that over to the symbols. You can see then it's added. Now I'm adding a dynamic symbol. Doesn't particularly matter, static or dynamic. Click OK. And now you can see you've got it in the symbols. Well, you can apply it. Just go over here. You've got a variety of different tools, symbol sprayer tool. And also you've noticed I've got them up here already. So I'm just going to quickly select the symbol sprayer. Just apply it all over the screen. Apply it multiple times. And you notice you've got a number of options here. You got symbol sizer. Now what I want to do is hold down the alter option key. And then you can resize them, make them a bit smaller. Because I don't want them to be all the same size. I don't want them massive. But I just want them slight different sizes. Just create things. And of course, because they're all circles, none of the others are particularly going to be useful. So rotation, etc. And you can shift things as well if you want to do that as well. But now you've got those done like that. What you can also do, you've got a number of other options here, such as the stainer. Stainer is really useful. You can just change the color. That's why I've got the colors panel here. So I've got colors and I can just set maybe to green. And then I can just go over there, just apply it very quickly to some areas of this side. Don't have to touch this side. Maybe change it to purple, lilac, apply it again. Now it's not instantaneous. Sometimes it takes a few seconds to think about it. Maybe go and select another color or two and you can stain the whole thing. So you can get obviously more than just reds and greens. Now, of course, you could, of course, create lots of circles, different colors. That would be just as easy, of course. But you can do it within the symbols themselves. So you've got that. Now, once you've got that design, you can resize it. You can, of course, create additional groups, maybe duplicate it, etc. But you can also add this to the symbols. So just drag over again to the symbols. Now, just dynamic symbol or static, perfectly reasonable. Click OK. And it will come up, must be expanded. Well, it does that. Fine. But it's saved it. That's the key thing. That's what I want. So I'm just going to remove that now. Now, what I can do, I can again go over here to the actual sprayer tool and apply it very quickly like that. And you can fill straight away the whole screen, whole image, the artboard with your dots. And again, you can do exactly the same as before. You can always resize them. Go over here, hold down the alter option key and resize some of them if you want to do that. And now, in this case, it actually is probably worth rotating. So you can apply the rotation to there. And you can see it does actually change things because, of course, the shape is now in a form that you can. So you've got this splatter of dots. Now, you don't have to, of course, use dots. I could use stars. I could use any shape to start with. So it could be a splatter design of anything. Well, hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.